So the first movie I have to recommend with you guys is Molly's Game, and this movie is on Netflix. It is so good. I just was obsessed with how it was filmed. It was just so good. Okay, I don't want to say too much and like spoil it, but it's really good. I love the storytelling in the movie. It's just so, yeah, that's it. This movie is on Netflix, but you can also find it illegally. The next movie that I have is What a Girl Wants. So this movie is also on Netflix, but knowing Netflix, they're probably gonna take it off. It is such a good movie. I love the plot. It is very, it's a very predictable movie. Like, you can pretty much predict what's gonna happen by like the middle of the movie, but it's just, it's a comfort movie of mine. I like going back and watching it with friends in sleepovers when I had them before COVID. So I thought this was a really cool movie to include. This movie is so good. Next we have Wild Child. This movie used to be on Netflix and then Netflix freaking took it off. Okay, I'm still so mad at Netflix for taking this movie off, because it's probably, it was one of the best movies on Netflix like ever. I would always watch it to my friends. I'd recommend it to my friends. I'd watch it with friends if they came over or something. Like, it's so good. Okay, like the plot, exquisite, and I love it. And the next show, well, this is still a movie. We're still on movies. And Wild Child is not on Netflix like I just expressed, but you can find it elsewhere. I believe it's on Amazon Prime. Also, we have The Prince and Me. So this movie is on Netflix. I believe they recently added it, like probably a couple months ago. Found it and I watched it, and it was so good. I feel like any movie with Julia Stiles in it is good. So it's amazing. I love the plot. It isn't as predictable, but still kind of predictable, but it's a good movie nonetheless. The next movie that I have is Crazy Rich Asians. It's so good. Okay, love Crazy Rich Asians, love all the plot twists, love everything about it. The first time I watched it, it was not a predictable plot, but the more and more that I watch it, the more that I realize like it's kind of predictable, but at the same time it's not. Like, there's a lot of twists and turns in the movies that you don't expect, that you don't see happening, and it just makes it more interesting. And just the costume design in the movie, the sets, oh, they're so good. Okay, I highly recommend to anyone. So the next movie that I have for you guys is 10 Things I Hate About You. So this is also another movie that has Julia Stiles in it. It's so good. It's just so good. I definitely see myself in Kat's character, just her attitude before she met the guy in the movie. I forget his name, but... And it's just a really good movie. It's a mellow enemies to lovers type thing. Like, they never even started out as enemies. They just like weren't friends and they didn't like each other. So I think it's kind of cool. It's a really nice movie. Highly recommend. The next movie that I have for you guys is Ocean's 8. So this movie is probably one of my all, it's up there on my list. Like, if you were to ask me like my top 10 movies, this would be like at least top 5. Ocean's 8 is so good. It is filmed professionally. I love the characters and the people that they cast to play the characters, and I love how it progresses. It was a unique movie. Like, the first time I watched it, I was kept on my toes, not enough to give me anxiety, but I was like interested in seeing what was next in the movie the first time I watched it, and I still go back and watch it for, you know, the plot. And it's just a good movie in general. I highly recommend it to anyone to watch. I think it's the best Ocean's movie. I know there's like Ocean's 11, Ocean's 9, blah, blah, blah. I think Ocean's 8 is the best Ocean's. Anyways, the next movie that I have is Instant Family. Now hear me out, okay. So the past movies that I've recommended, a lot of them have been like comedy, some rom-coms, some thriller suspense type thing. Not thriller, but more suspense. But Instant Family is more like, it really is a family movie. I don't wanna give too much away about it, but I feel like it did a very good job of finding a balance between showing reality and also adding a bunch of comedic and dramatic effect to it. It's a really good movie. I highly recommend it to anyone to watch. Once I watched Instant Family, I've kind of fallen in love with Isabella Merced, who is the actress who plays one of the characters in the movie. And the last movie that I have is The Midnight Sky. So this movie is actually on Netflix and it is a Netflix original. So Netflix actually, you know, produced it and directed it, and it is pretty good. It was a little bit boring at first, like for the first like 30-ish minutes, but then it starts to like speed up and add some more intenseness into it. I would say that it's in between sci-fi and reality. Like, what happens in the movie could definitely happen in real life, but it is a little bit more dramatified, which is why I classify it as science fiction. But it's a really good movie. I enjoyed it. Now we're going to move into all of these shows that I have to recommend for you guys. So the first show, and probably the most popular show right now on Netflix in terms of like teens and young adults, is Bridgerton. If you have not seen Bridgerton, you've not heard of it, I think you've been living under a rock, because it's been talked about on social media, Twitter, TikTok, Instagram even, and it lives up to the hype. There's a few scenes in the show that I heavily disagree with, and I feel like the director should have cut out, but Bridgerton is an amazing show nonetheless. Less the costumes, I've heard people saying that they're pretty accurate to the times, and they're beautiful as well, and the sets and the actors and actresses that they cast are just, they fit the characters, they really do. And I really enjoyed watching it. I love watching a lot of shows and movies that are set in like Regency, Victorian era, so I really enjoyed this movie. So the next show that I'm going to talk about is The Babysitter's Club. So if you don't remember, in elementary school, The Babysitter's Club's books were like holy grail. They were good books, okay, and I read all of them. You know, they turned I believe the first book into a movie, and in terms of accuracy, they definitely didn't keep to the books, but the movie was good nonetheless. I feel like it's a very casual, like middle school preteen show, and it's not like boring. I watched it, like plot was really good, and I'm looking forward to the next season, but it was a good show nonetheless. So the next show that I have is Spinning Out on Netflix, but Spinning Out is amazing. It's really, really good. I heavily enjoyed it. I don't know what else to say. It was so good. Okay. It was really, really good. I loved the characters. I loved the twists and turns and everything. And I think it showed really a good perspective in terms of competitive sports and how toxic they can be towards students and the injuries that people can face from it and everything like that. It's just a really good show. So the next show that I have, we have Hawaii Five-O, and I originally watched this on Netflix, but I believe now Netflix has taken it out. Just like they do with every good thing, they take it off. So Hawaii Five-O used to be on Netflix. I'm not sure if it's on Netflix or it's another streaming platform, but it was so good. I stopped watching it a while back just because I got so much anxiety from it, because it's a crime show. It's just showing like them stopping bad guys, and I got too much anxiety. Too much. Like, it was a good show. I enjoyed the plot, I enjoyed the characters, I enjoyed the love triangles, I enjoyed all of it, but I could not keep on having nightmares, okay? The next show that I have is Married to Medicine LA. So I actually watched Married to Medicine LA before I watched the original Married to Medicine, which is set in Atlanta. But Married to Medicine in LA was probably one of the first reality shows that I've actually enjoyed. Like, I felt like it was a good show, and I'm interested in seeing another season. Like, unlike other reality shows, like I feel like some reality shows, they just blow drama out of proportion, they blow like minor details out of proportion to make the show like a show. But this show, there was like actual like true like friendship fights, like jealousy, envy, all of that mixed in together with the fact that they're all successful women. It was a really enjoyable show to watch, and I'm very excited and hopeful that they will continue with it and give us another season with the same people, because it's not characters, they're actual people, and these are their actual lives and friendships and stuff like that. So I'm pretty excited about that, and I highly recommend it for anyone to watch. It's a really good show just in general. And the last show and the last recommendation that I have for you guys is Dream Home Makeover. So this is a show on Netflix actually, and this is following Studio McGee, basically like Netflix's version of HGTV shows. But this show is following Studio McGee, which is a husband and a wife who started their own design company, and they design houses now like for commission. Like, you can ask them to renovate a part of your house or your whole house or build you a house, and they do all of that. And I think it's really cool to watch. I love her design. Her designing is both simple yet farmhouse yet modern. Like, she just really does really well at combining a bunch of different styles and not making the home feel too white, but also not making the home feel like it's cluttered and busy. And it's a really good show. Highly recommend. I love it.